have like a top three at the moment of the different hair companies that I've tried as far as blonde hair that I'm liking. I'll probably put that in the description box of like my top three, not in really any order, but you know, these are like my top favorite companies in blonde hair that I've used. So I told you guys a while back, and you guys pretty much gave me your opinion. I got so much positive feedback from my last tutorial, which is just shocker because that video was super last minute and I was running out literally to go to brunch in New York City with my friends, and I decided why not just kind of turn on the camera, show you guys what I like to do as far as laying down my frontals, and you guys loved it. So I'm definitely going to be doing more celebrity stylists or celebrity, you know, hairstylists, you know, BTS behind the scenes type of videos, letting you guys know different secrets and different tips that people have used or like to use, or I like to use, and similarities that we have as far as doing wigs and all that good stuff. So as far as the basics of me doing my wig, I'm just doing pretty much everything I always do. As far as me making my wigs, there's nothing really different. I do my wigs on a machine weft. I do machine weft wigs as far as giving to my clients, just because you guys are paying a lot of money as far as getting wigs for me. So I want to make sure that my quality is up to par, and you're going to be having a wig for a very long time. The longevity of the wigs are going to be spectacular, as well as having really good quality hair. So as far as me making my own wigs, I pretty much do like the hand sewn method. But for me making my wigs for my clients, I do use a sewing machine because it just lasts a lot longer. It's a little bit more tedious when making the wigs that way, but it's worth it because the quality of the wig is a lot more professional than a hand sewn wig. So I'm just showing you guys how I like to place my inches apart from each other as far as sewing it. Everything is pretty much the same. I still do use nylon thread and dome mesh caps when making my wig. I also use the same thing as far as using T-pens. I got it from Amazon. Pretty much everything that I use is still the same, is from Amazon. Or you can just go to your local beauty supply store if you don't feel like waiting. I have Amazon Prime, so usually I can get it in that same day, or I get it in next day, or you know, 2 day shipping or anything like that. But yeah, if you're not lazy like me and just, you know, want to just go to the store and get it ASAP, then just go to your beauty supply store, and I'm pretty sure they have everything that I'm using in this video. I am giving you guys a close-up as far as the wefts on the Peerless bundles. One pet peeve that I have, I mean, I will still do it if I need to, but I love to sew my wefts when the bundles are, well, it's the weft, the sewn part of the weft is a lot more flexible and thin, like the ones from Peerless. I hate using super thick wefts because it's so hard to sew, especially if you're doing hand sewing like me in this video. But if you guys are using sewing machines, I don't really think it really affects it or matters. But as far as me from hand sewing my own wigs, I love that these wefts are a lot more flexible and thin and a lot more easier to maneuver. So I'm just going ahead and just going to the Kiss Colors part of the video. You guys already know this is like probably my favorite type of dye to use. I have like a top two dyes that I really like. As far as just putting the hand application on, I like to use the Arctic Fox dyes, and I love to use the Kiss Colors dyes. But if you guys are doing it the watercolor method, which in my personal opinion, I don't really care for, but some people really do like to use the watercolor method. But in my personal opinion, I like the Adore dyes a lot better for watercolor. And for hand coloring, I like the two that I named. To me, they aren't really that good. Kiss Colors and Arctic Fox aren't really the best when it comes to watercolor. But for some odd reason, Adore is the bomb when it comes to watercolor. So I'll probably put that down in the description box as well. If anyone is wondering what kind of dyes that I love to use, another thing that I'm going to be telling you guys is when it comes to a celebrity secret that I like to do as far as blending the colors. This has been like the most top rated thing when it comes to people not really understanding how I get my blend to be like so perfect and seamless to you guys. And my honest opinion for you guys is to use colors that are able to blend really well with each other, and use colors as far as when you mix them, they create another color. So obviously the colors pink and yellow make orange. You guys have to pretty much study the whole color wheel, because that would just really tell you guys what colors are good to mix together and what colors go. I do have a lot of tutorials where I just literally just smack a ton of colors together and just make it work, but I don't blend them together if I know personally that they're not going to be blending well. So pink and yellow makes the perfect orange color. So I like to put the pink ahead and then the yellow on the bottom, and then just pretty much integrate and mix them to create a very natural orange. I could have just did pink and then orange and then yellow, but because it's going to be a bob and short, you're not really going to have that much space to blend all three of those colors together. So my ultimate tip for you guys, if you are having a short bob like this one in this video that I'm doing, I would advise you to get colors that you're going to be able to mesh together to create a third color, so that you're not using a ton of colors for something so short and you're not really going to be able to fit everything on such a short length of hair. So I just went ahead and put the colors Cyan and Azure on the wig. I didn't even end up using a Moonlight and Hawaiian Fire. I know I showed it in the beginning of the video, but like I said, I noticed that I was not going to be able to fit everything all into this short bob, so I just decided to use my brain, you know what I'm saying, know how to mix colors together. Again, study that color wheel, because that I really teach you guys as far as color theory, and I just meshed them together to make a third color and it worked perfectly. And another thing I want to let you guys know is as far as the lace and not getting your colors to stain, the biggest tip for me is to use an applicator that is a very firm brush, brush bristles, say that 5 times 5, because it is very stiff and is able to just really penetrate and push through the hair, not get the color onto the lace. Blue, purple, and red are the top three colors, that in black also, black, they are the top four colors as far as staining the lace when it comes to wigs. So in my opinion, if you're going to be using any four of those colors, get the applicator brush that I just showed you guys in the video. I will also link it down below. It is from Ion. It has been my absolute go-to brush when it comes to putting on colors on my lace, because it's so freaking fast, so quick, and it does not stain the lace at all. So I just went ahead off camera and washed the hair out. I did not condition it, only because Kiss Colors is a conditioning dye. So I've learned that when I don't condition it, I like it a little bit better, because when I do condition it, I feel like if when I let it sit, the colors kind of mesh together and make it like ilk. So I actually just stopped conditioning the hair. It doesn't really matter, because Kiss Colors, like I said, conditions the hair anyway with the argan oil in it. So it's no worries. It doesn't really affect it. But you guys can see how bomb this hair is. I pretty much never do this on video when it comes to companies, but I had to like pause real quick because I'm like, yo, this hair is so bomb. Like, it's so good, and it's so good for it to be so affordable. And on top of that, from AliExpress. Now, as far as the longevity, I'll probably say this hair will be able to last you guys about 6 or 7 months. This is definitely not like a year-long type of hair. That's when you have to go a little bit more on the more expensive side using Eurasian Blonde. If you guys want something that will last about 6 months, depending on how long you wear your hair, that is definitely another thing you guys need to take in consideration, because if you wear your wigs every day, obviously the longevity is going to shorten. You're not really going to be able to wear it a lot longer than some that wear their wigs probably once a week, twice a week, 3 times a week, you know. So it also takes in the fact, you also have to make all that into consideration when getting your hair and knowing what kind of hair to buy from AliExpress or any other expensive company that's out there. So I told you guys this is going to be a start to finish type of video. I'm going to be showing you guys how I literally took this hair and cut it into this bob all on camera, and I do show you guys how I cut the bangs. So the biggest tip that I have for you guys, that is also another celebrity secret, is to tilt your mannequin about at least 45 to 30 degrees forward, just because you're really going to be able to see the back of the bob, and that's going to be like the biggest statement in creating your bob. So once you tilt your head forward, you'll be able to see a better view of how you need to cut. Also, you want to make sure that your scissors are facing upward. Never cut with your scissors going horizontal. That is a huge no-no and the biggest mistake that I had when I was first cutting hair. You want to make sure that you tilt your mannequin and make sure that your scissors are going in a vertical direction, because that makes the most natural bluntness. So make sure that your scissors are going in a vertical direction, because it's going to give you the most precise, clean, and cut bob ever. And also another tip for you guys that still have no idea how to cut your hair in a bob to be perfected, is on the bottom of the canvas head, it's going to be like a block. It's going to be like super hard in the block. If you want a super short bob like how I have in the video, when you're cutting in a vertical direction, you're going to be hitting that block. When your scissors start to hit that block on the end of the canvas head, that's how you know that's the area that you need to start stopping and cutting. Don't go any higher than that if you want it to be on pretty much your neck and a super short bob like how I did in the video. So when you're cutting in a vertical direction, I don't know if that's making any sense to you guys, but basically, tilt your mannequin head cut in a vertical direction, and when you're cutting all the way up until you hit the bottom of the canvas, that's where you stop, and just do the same thing. It doesn't matter where you go when it comes to flat iron hair and all that stuff. Every single time you go higher, still make sure that you're cutting all the way up into the bottom of the canvas head, and that's pretty much going to be your guide. So I did the same thing all throughout the entire head, same thing, cut it until I get to like the bottom of the canvas head, and just keep doing the same thing. I don't know if that makes any sense to y'all. I'm trying to explain this as best of my ability, but it is like so simpler and easier if you guys just watched it, and you'll really pretty much know like the whole gist of how to like, do everything.
I'm catching all the feelings. I forget that we are only human beings. You've been giving me extraterrestrial readings. I love you, I mean it if you do. Tell me we're sipping the same brew. Hooked on the Kool-Aid, I'm thirsty for good news.
I love you more than I love myself, boy. And I love myself way too fucking much. Don't you play with me. I love you more than I love myself, boy. And my love for you caught it from the jump. I love you more than I love myself, boy. And I love myself way too fucking much. Don't you play with me. I love you more than I love myself, boy. And my love for you caught it from the jump.
Fuck, I want you to show up. Will you throw me a bone? I've been out here making lemonade with all your lemons. You would think by now that I'd have learned 100 lessons. But I'm stupid with it. Cut, feel the burn of another scene. I don't wanna get mean on my 16th, but you'll never wanna listen to me when I beg and plead. Bitch, I don't wanna have it your way, I want you to have it mine. It's a give a little, take a little, but you only taking all the time. You got me twisted, dot my T's and cross my eyes. I'm in denial, it's too late to compromise. I love you, I mean it if you do. Tell me what's sipping the same brew. Hooked on the Kool-Aid, I'm thirsty for good news.
I love you more than I love myself, boy. And I love myself way too fucking much. Don't you play with me.
Don't play.
I love you more than I love myself, boy. And my love for you caught it from the jump. I love you more than I love myself, boy. And I love myself way too fucking much. Don't you play with me. I love you more than I love myself, boy. And my love for you caught it from the jump.
Unspoken. Sometimes we're not happy, but we never are broken, are we? Even on an island by ourselves, girl, you make me happy, can't you tell? If I gotta be stranded, then I wanna be stranded with you. Every morning I'ma be right here, stranded with you. Feeling better since you brought me here.
Guys, now that I've pretty much just cut the entire hair into the bob, we're now going to move on to doing the bang. I will show you guys the lace a little bit later because I do show you that none of this dye got onto the lace using my method. This is the best method, like I said, for using any blue tones, any purple tones, any red tones, or any black or brown tones, because you do not get the hair, you do not get the color on the lace at all, and it does look so natural and so seamless by just using that one applicator brush like I showed you guys in the video, and I will also link it down below in the description. So the easiest way to create the fringe bangs, or the super long natural bangs that I always show you guys in my pictures and my videos, is to turn your canvas head to the opposite side. You want to make sure that your canvas head is facing a number, like you're able to look directly at the number, because you want to use that little hump in the back as your makeshift forehead. It mimics like a forehead in the eyes of a natural human being. So I like to just pretty much cut at the end of the hump, because that's going to create the long super bangs. What the hell is that? Well, that's just going to create the perfect bangs for falling that someone like me, I don't like too much of a super thick bang. I like something a little bit more natural, looks so effortless and seamless. It's pretty long, but it's not too long, and they're like the perfect length. So when you guys just do it as easy as this, you probably like, how the hell did I think of that? I mistakenly did it one day. Like, I was just like, you know, I want to cut a bang, and I was like, I have no idea how long I want it, but I'm just going to randomly cut it like this, and hopefully is good. And I noticed that when I did it, cut it like this, it was the perfect size bangs, and I just been cutting my bangs like this ever since. So it's something as simple as that, you guys. Just turn your canvas head to the opposite side to the number, and just cutting it on the lower end of the hump, and it's literally the perfect bang. Then all I do is go ahead and take my flat iron, do a little bump on it, and your bangs are done. I do, like I said, show you guys later on in the video how the hairline looks and how the lace looks and how none of the dye got onto the lace. It's absolutely perfect. Some people like to do the watercolor method when using a little bit more of a tricky colors with reds and blues and stuff, but to my opinion, that still stains the knots. It may not stain the lace, but it does turn the knots like a blue color or whatever color that you're using. Like I said, I'm not a big fan of watercolor. I still feel like, number one, either stains the lace, or number two, it stains the knots and it doesn't look as effortless. I'm a good old-fashioned just apply the color onto the head with my hands type of girl, and I just get the best results when doing it that way. It only took me about 2 hours to do this wig. I was pretty freaking shocked. Well, it only took me 2 hours to dye it, but it only took me 2 hours or 2.5 hours to dye this hair. It was like the most lazy application ever. I was actually dreading on doing this video just because I just have been so lazy as far as dyeing wigs, because they just take me super long sometimes. But I've been getting so faster and faster and faster when doing wigs with color, just because you just pretty much longer over time, learn different techniques and learn different things, it's going to be easier for you. This is what I mean, but I was just showing you guys all the detail of the lace on the wig, and none of the color got on the knots and none of the color had got on the lace, and it just looks so bomb and effortless. This is a Nipsey Blue, obviously in remembrance of Nipsey Hussle. You guys already know it's all over the freaking world that he passed away, unfortunately, rest in peace. But I decided to make a wig. Some artists, you know, like to do drawing, some artists like to do paintings and all that different stuff, but you know, I'm an artist, I like to do wigs. So I did Nipsey Blue, obviously, for the king. I did the baby blue in honorance of his son. I did the pink in honorance of his daughter, and then I did the yellow in honorance of Lauren London, because it's always going to be light at the end of the tunnel and it's only going to get better. So unfortunately, you know, I was kind of contemplating if I really want to do this video or not, but you know, there's nothing wrong with honoring somebody for exactly who they were. And it's very unfortunate with his passing, I'm not gonna lie. I was never the biggest Nipsey Hussle fan, not to say that I didn't like him, but I just never listened to his music. And after the whole passing situation, I feel like his album was one of the best albums I've freaking heard up until this day, like honestly. And it's so crazy, but yeah. So I just decided to do a wig in honor of that, and then also because this wig was a bomb color to do, because this blue is bomb.com. But it's kind of weird to say this video, but you know, it's a very unfortunate type of circumstance, but I feel like I kind of just brought joy to the whole situation a little bit, and you guys got to see my face. Hey! So I hope to see you guys in my next video. I love you guys times 1,000. The next video is going to be... Oh, the next video is going to be talking about my vendors as far as hair and stuff, and showing you guys how I like to start, or how I started my business. So That's going to be a very informative video, because I told you I'm trying to get a little bit more informative for my videos. So hope to see you guys in that video. It's going to be super lit and good. I do expose a lot of vendors that you guys can get started with as far as your business. And I hope to see you guys in my next one. Bye, guys. Stranded with you, feeling better since you brought me.